Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. In the first part of this video, we have seen that how to generate a triangular wave using the astable multivibrator and the integrator circuit. So in this video, we will see the second method and we will see that how we can generate a triangular wave using the Schmitt trigger and the integrator circuit. So here is the circuit diagram for the triangular wave generator. And as you can see, the first part of the circuit is the Schmitt trigger circuit and the second part of the circuit is the integrator. And if you observe, there is a feedback from the output of the integrator to the Schmitt trigger circuit. So first of all, let us understand the working of this triangular wave generator. Now if you are aware, this Schmitt trigger is nothing but the comparator with the hysteresis, meaning that whenever the voltage at this non-inverting node just go above or below this 0 volt, then the output of this comparator will get changed. And it will change between the positive saturation voltage and the negative saturation voltage. And these two voltages will act as an input for this integrator circuit. So this integrator circuit integrates this voltage for the finite time. And the integrated voltage will be given as a feedback to this Schmitt trigger circuit. So initially, let us assume that the output of the Schmitt trigger is equal to positive saturation voltage. So in that case, this integrator will start integrating this positive saturation voltage. So depending upon the value of this R3 and C1, the integrator will integrate this positive saturation voltage. And as soon as this voltage just crosses some threshold voltage, then you will see a transition in the output of the Schmitt trigger from positive saturation voltage to the negative saturation voltage. And once there is a transition from positive to negative saturation voltage, then this integrator will start integrating this negative saturation voltage. And once again, when this integrator reaches some finite threshold voltage, then you will see a transition from the negative saturation voltage to the positive saturation voltage. So the output of this integrator will decide transition point for this Schmitt trigger. Now if you observe, for this Schmitt trigger, there are two inputs at this non-inverting end. One is the output of this Schmitt trigger itself, that is either positive or the negative saturation voltage, and the one input is the output from this integrator circuit. So if we see the voltage at this non-inverting node, it will be a summation due to the voltage at this node, let's say that is V1, and the voltage at this node. So we can write this V plus as the R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times this voltage V1 plus R1 divided by R1 plus R2 times Vx. So basically, this expression is written by considering only one voltage source at a time. So if we consider this voltage source V1 alone, at that time, we have assumed that this Vx is equal to 0. And just by using the voltage divider rule, we can find the voltage at this node. So this will be the total voltage which will appear at this non-inverting node. And whenever this voltage just goes above or below this 0 volt, then you will see a transition in the Schmitt trigger output. So initially, let us assume that the output of the Schmitt trigger is equal to positive saturation voltage. And in that case, let us find out the value of this Vx. So if we assume that this V1 is equal to Vset, in that case, this V plus will be equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times Vset plus R1 divided by R1 plus R2 times Vx. And let us equate this expression to the 0, because whenever this voltage V plus will become 0, you will see a transition in the output. So equating this expression to the 0 and solving for Vx, we will get the value of Vx as minus R2 divided by R1 times Vset. So this will be the one of the threshold voltage which will decide the output of this Schmitt trigger. And if we assume this V1 as a negative saturation voltage, that means minus Vset, in that case we will get the second expression. So let us say this is equal to Vx1, which is the one threshold point, and the second threshold point will be equal to Vx2, which will be equal to R2 divided by R1 times Vset. So this will be the upper threshold point and this will be the lower threshold point. And in the graph, we can say that this is equal to Vx2 and this is equal to Vx1, where Vx2 is equal to R2 divided by R1 times Vset, and Vx1 is equal to minus R2 divided by R1 times Vset. So whenever the output of the integrator just crosses this Vx2 voltage, then you will see a transition from the negative saturation voltage to the positive saturation voltage. And likewise, whenever it crosses this lower threshold voltage, then you will see a transition from the positive saturation voltage to the negative saturation voltage. Now, if you observe, the triangular wave voltage is varying between this upper and the lower threshold voltage. So we can find the peak-to-peak voltage from these two voltages. That means V peak-to-peak for the triangular wave will be equal to Vx2 minus Vx1. Or we can say that it is equal to 2 times R2 divided by R1 times Vset. So this will be the peak-to-peak voltage for the triangular wave. Now let us find out the equation of the frequency for this triangular wave. Now if you see over here, the integrator integrates this positive or the negative saturation voltage for this T/2 time period. So we can say that this V peak-to-peak voltage will be equal to minus 1 by RC times integration 0 to T/2 V in times dt. So this will be the output of the integrator if we integrate the input voltage for the T/2 time period. So in this case, this peak-to-peak voltage will be equal to minus 1 by R3 times C1 multiplied by minus Vset times T/2. And here, the value of this peak-to-peak voltage is equal to 2 times R2 divided by R1 times Vset. So if we simplify this expression, then we will get T/2 times 1 by R3 times C1 multiplied by Vset. And if we simplify this expression in terms of this time period T, then this T will be equal to 4 times R3 R2 times C1 divided by R1. Or we can say that the frequency F will be equal to R1 divided by 4 times R3 R2 times C1. So this will be the expression of a frequency for the triangular wave. Now using these expressions, let us design one triangular wave which has a specific frequency as well as the peak-to-peak voltage. So let's say we want to design a one triangular wave which has a frequency of 2 kHz and a peak-to-peak voltage of 7 volt. So first of all, let us find out the value of R2 and R1 which is required to get this desired peak-to-peak voltage. So we know that the peak-to-peak voltage can be given as 2 times R2 divided by R1 times Vset. And here, let us assume that the op-amp which we are using has a saturation voltage of 14 volt. So from this, the ratio of R1 and R2 should be equal to 2 times 14 volt divided by 7 volt, which is equal to 4. That means the ratio of R1 and R2 should be in a proportion of 4. So let's say R1 is equal to 40 kilo ohm and R2 is equal to 10 kilo ohm. Now similarly, let us find out the value of R3 and C1 which is required to get this 2 kHz frequency. Now we know that the frequency F can be given by the expression R1 divided by 4 times R3 R2 times C1. Now here the frequency F is equal to 2 kHz and we already know the value of R1 and R2. That means R1 is equal to 40 kilo ohm and R2 is equal to 10 kilo ohm. So here we need to find the value of this R3 and C1 so that we can get the 2 kHz frequency. So here let us assume that the value of C1 is equal to 0.01 microfarad, and let us simplify this expression in terms of R3. So if we simplify this expression, then the value of R3 will come around as 50 kilo ohm. That means for our design, the value of R1 should be equal to 40 kilo ohm, while the value of R2 should be equal to 10 kilo ohm. And here we have assumed C1 as 0.01 microfarad, and from this the value of R3 is equal to 50 kilo ohm. So using these values, we should get a triangular wave of 2 kilohertz frequency with a peak to peak voltage of 7 volt. So let us simulate this circuit using the multisim and let us validate our design. So here I have already connected this circuit according to the designed values. And for the simulation, here I am using the op-amp LM324. And here I have connected the two probes at the output of the Schmitt trigger as well as the integrator. Now here, just one thing to notice, the order of this resistor is slightly different from the schematic which we have discussed earlier. So anyway, let us run this simulation and let us see the output of this triangular wave generator. So if we run the simulation, then we will get this kind of waveform. So for a minute, let me just stop the simulation. So first of all, let us find out the peak to peak voltage of this triangular wave. So if you observe, at one end we have a voltage of 4 volt, while at the other end we have a voltage of minus 3.5 volt. That means the peak to peak voltage is roughly around 7.5 volt. And now let us also see the frequency of this triangular wave. So at this end, the x-axis is equal to 68.051 millisecond, and at this end it is equal to 68.67. So roughly there is a difference of 0.5 millisecond between these two peaks. That means the frequency f for this triangular wave generator is equal to 2 kilohertz. Now here we can tune this peak to peak voltage by changing the value of this R3 and R1, and according to our schematic, by changing the value of R2 and R1. Now here, let me just tune the value of this R3 so that we can get the exact peak to peak voltage of 7 volt. So here, if I change the value of this R3 from 40 to 45 kilo ohm, then we should get a peak to peak voltage of 7 volt. So now if you see, at one end, now the peak to peak voltage is 3.7 volt, and at the other end of the triangular wave, it is equal to minus 3.3 volt. So now the peak to peak voltage is equal to 7 volt. That means by tuning these two resistors, we can get the exact value of desired peak to peak voltage. So I hope in this video, you understood how we can design a triangular wave generator using the Schmitt trigger and the integrator circuit. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.